Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
Hey, bro, do you hear what the Bible is saying? Where your fringe is at, bro?
Look, check this out.
I know. You gotta order some more? Okay, come holler at us, bro. We gonna get you right. Did you read the flyer? You already know about what?
I'm a Hebrew Israelite. From the tribe of Judah. I already know Christ is coming back. He's a man of war. His father's a man of war. Yahweh, his father's a man of war.
Right.
He's coming back for the 12 tribes. At the end of the day, you gotta keep his commandments. And you gotta follow his law to the best of our ability. But I understand you're not gonna keep the law 100%, but we still gotta fight because we're not taking this flesh with us. Cherries come, we gonna get beamed up. We not taking none of this stuff with us. At the end of the day, his father name, and his name, not Yahweh Shah. I already know about it.
Okay, bro, so quick question though. With all that being said though,
Right, so with all that being said, bro,
you say you ain't got no friends, you gotta order.
Yeah, I gotta order some more, bro. Y'all got a website to order some more?
Yeah, you ain't read the flyer we gave it to you, bro.
I already got the flyer, so I gotta order some more.
Yeah, bro, you gotta order some more friends, bro. Remember, it said throughout your generations, correct?
Yeah.
So you understand you gotta do it continually.
Today is the Sabbath, yeah, I know I gotta be the holy.
So, alright, okay, where you going, bro?
Right here, real quick. I
make some runs. You gotta make some runs on the Sabbath day. What the Lord command you to do on the Sabbath day, bro?
Bring it up.
To rest.
Huh?
To rest.
So, okay, so you say you gotta make some runs.
The day when the Father created, he was done with everything. He was done, you know what I'm saying? Earth for 7,000 years.
Because he was done on the seventh day. Give me Genesis chapter 2.
I know, bro.
Okay, so if you say you know, when you said he created, you say you know. We're gonna clarify real quick. Genesis chapter 2, verse 1.
This is the book of Genesis, chapter 2, verse 1.
Bring it out.
Reincarnation.
I know.
I might not see it like
thus that. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished.
Listen up, bro.
Hey, what's your name, bro? What's your name?
Yasin Roba.
What?
Yasin Roba.
Yasin Roba?
Yeah.
Okay, listen up, Yasin Roba.
Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the hosts of them. And on the seventh day, God ended his work which he had made, and he rested and the seventh day from all his works which he had made. And God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it, because that in it he had rested from all his works which God created and made.
So call it and read it again. This is the book of Genesis. Genesis mean what?
Beginning.
What?
Beginning.
The beginning. The book Genesis means the beginning. Read.
Chapter 2 and verse 1.
The book of Genesis, chapter 2, and verse 1.
Thus the heavens and the earth were finished.
So it's going into the creation of everything. We're in the second chapter. So God created the heaven and the earth was finished. Read.
And all the hosts of them.
And all the hosts meaning
everything in it. All the hosts. Read.
And on the seventh day.
On which day?
The seventh day.
The 700th day.
The seventh day.
The seventh day. Did you say it when you came up? You said the 700th day.
I said 700. I said Saturday. I thought I used to go by the moon and all that. You know what I'm saying? It's really a lot of what the Esau they taught us.
Okay, I got you, brother. I'm going to deal with you, but you got to be patient. Listen good. Read.
And on the seventh day, God ended his work, which he had made, and he rested on the seventh day.
On the seventh day. You understand that? What is today? Because I know you said something about the calendar and everything is different off, right? Hold this, give me Judges, the fifth chapter.
Right,
brother, you have to listen though, because a lot of this ain't our words. You understand? This is the word of the Most High, and He got an answer for everything in order for you to keep His commandments properly in this present time. Listen good.
This is the book of Judges, chapter 5, and verse 11.
Bring it out.
They that are delivered from the noise of Arcus in the places of dry water, they shall rehearse the righteous acts of the Lord, even the righteous acts toward the inhabitants of his villages in Israel.
So, call it and read it again. Read.
This is the book of Judges.
Book of Judges. Read on.
Chapter 5, in verse 11. They that are delivered from the noise of archers in the...
Stop. So they that are delivered from the noise of archers, read.
In the places of dry water.
And where?
In the places of dry water.
So that is when you're in a place where you have to draw water, you're in a servitude state. Or you're in a captive state. Remember, because the Lord said he's going to take us to put us in captivity. So right now, are we in a captive state? Are we still in captivity?
Yeah.
So we are right now in the day of drawing. Read that part again. Drawing what?
Delivered from the noise of archers in the places of drawing water.
That's right now today, because we're in a servitude or a captive state. That means right now. You understand? Read.
There shall they rehearse the righteous acts of the...
Let's read it again. Yeah.
There shall they rehearse the righteous acts.
There. Wherever you at, right now we in where? Right, okay, but what's the name of the place we in? Babylon the Great, or better yet, known as America, right? So he said there. Right, spiritual Egypt. But there, right here in America, shall you do what?
Rehearse the righteous acts of the Lord.
So right here, we should rehearse the righteous acts of the Lord. Bridges is a righteous act of the Lord. So we have to get out of this ideology of making excuses on why we can't keep the commandments. You can find an excuse for everywhere.
You know what I mean? No.
Hey, sister. Hey, sis. You got any questions?
Yeah,
I said,
you gotta take a picture of him. Take a picture.
Take a picture?
Yeah.
I got you.
Hey, what tribe you from, sis?
From Chicago.
From where?
Chicago.
Chicago?
Chicago.
What is the... Chicago? Okay. Well, okay, so I'm asking what tribe you from. Look on this sign right there. What tribe you come from? On the right, you got your slave master name, and on the left, you got your biblical name. Hey, bro, hold on, bro. We ain't done with you yet. The Lord ain't done with you. You ain't got nothing to do today. It's the Lord's Sabbath day. You must do what?
Sisters.
Rest and listen to the word of God. What's that, sis?
Sisters.
You from Sisters?
We sisters. Are we sisters?
Okay, sister, hold on 1 second. Give me Leviticus 21:5. Because remember, brother, the Lord got rules on how we must deal with each other. I mean, excuse me, the Lord got rules on how we must conduct ourselves, how we must look. Read what you got when you get it. Leviticus chapter 1, excuse me, 21 and the 5th verse.
This is
the
name again, bro?
Yasaroba. You're going to have to be patient with me. That's a difficult name. Read.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 21, in verse 5. They shall not make baldness upon their head, neither shall they shave off the corners of their beard, nor make any cuttings in their flesh.
You hear that, Yasaroba? So what are you supposed to do with your beard? Do you mar your beard? The Lord ain't saying necessarily not no lines. It's okay to
keep it neat.
Yeah, keep it neat, but he's talking about more into it, cut into it. You're not supposed to do that. You understand that? I pray that you do, bro. Hey, so look.
Even though it's all equal, as you say, it's about the limit.
law is cool.
We ain't gonna keep the law 100%, but he said what he said. The law is not really done away with. But a lot of people get through with Paul Wright, but it gave no sense.
Well, give me a B.E. first. How long have you been knowing you was an Israelite, bro?
About a year and a half.
About a year and a half. Who you congregate with? You congregate with GMS? That's who you congregate with right now? Great Millstone? Okay. Read this when you did it.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 5, in verse 48. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect.
So who is that speaking? Who is this speaking? Who is this speaking? This is Christ speaking. The book, call it and read it again. Recall it and read it again.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 5, in verse 48. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect.
So you hear what that said? What makes a man perfect? Keeping the law, statutes, and commandments. Christ wouldn't say that if it wasn't possible.
Run.
So you have to do what? Keep the commandments. You can't make an excuse on why you can't keep them. You can't, you know what I mean? You have to get that excuse making out of your head. You understand?
Bring it on.
Honestly, I'm going to tell you something. You got to be around righteous men in order to do so.
That's right. Bring it on.
You have to be around righteous brothers. Read that when you get it. What you got?
Let's see it
like. Okay. Hey, bro, how you doing today, brother? My name is Amaya. What's your name, bro?
Chuck.
Yeah.
I'm a born again believer.
Huh?
I'm a born again believer.
You a born again believer.
Yeah.
Okay, so you believe in Jesus Christ?
That's my Lord and Savior.
Okay, so you believe in Jesus Christ?
Yeah.
Hold that real quick.
And that's how the Holy Spirit come in you.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna get one scripture. Hold that on. What's your name again, bro?
Chuck.
Read the Hebrews. All right, Chuck, brother, give me 1 second. Do you believe this right here, Chuck? Read this when you got it.
This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, in verse 25.
Bring it out.
Not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together, as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much the more, as ye see the day approaching.
You hear that, brother? Yeah. So we're gonna call it and read it again. We're gonna call it and read it again slow. Hey, bro, listen good. Read it again.
This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, in verse 25.
Bring it out.
Not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together.
So what is that talking about? Not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together. Not forsaking the assembly of yourself together. When you assemble together, that means you're gathering. You're congregating.
Right.
Okay? So
it
says, don't forsake that. You understand that? So, read on.
As the manner of some is.
As the manner of some is, which is non-believers. They don't know Israel. They don't even believe in the scriptures. You, as a believing Israelite brother, you supposed to not forsake it. As the matter of some is, meaning do it. Read.
But exhorting one another.
So exhort one another daily. Okay, so how we exhort one another? If you was around righteous man, brother's going to teach you the way of preaching. Brother, you might say, I don't got none. Brother's going to get you some. Because we understand how important the commandments of God is.
Right.
Remember, the reason why we in this condition is because of what? Friends is a commandment. So if you continue to walk in that manner, what are you saying ultimately? What are you saying ultimately if you continue to walk in sin? Meaning you comfortable here. You okay with being here. Especially knowing you gotta do better. You understand that?
Bring it out.
Read.
And so much the more as ye see the day approaching.
And so much the more when we see judgment, as we see Christ on his way back. That's the day that's approaching. That's the day that's approaching. So we must be around each other to exhort you to wear your fringes. Don't wear your beard. Keep the commandments. Today is the Sabbath day. You can't be going out making runs. You got to be congregating, not forsaking the assembly.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC, has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.